But as a game in the end, I take a shack on a rock over a castle in the sand. Now he works all day and cries alone at night. It's not getting any better. Looks like he's running out of time. 'Cause he worked and he rebuilt with his own two hands. And he poured all he had in a castle made with sand. But the wind and the rain are coming crashing in. Time will tell just how long his kingdom stays.
I'm Pastor Paul Marzon. It's a joy to be with you as we discuss the best story ever. As we've been continuing to walk through the Hebrew Scriptures or the Old Testament, we're learning each week about another section of the people of Israel. And right now we're in a section called the Kings. We've seen good kings like King Saul and King David and King Solomon. Now we've been discussing evil kings and a divided kingdom between North and South. And today we pick it up in the section Family Devo 31. And it says, God sometimes faithful Judah. In other words, at least while the northern tribe had no good kings, at least southern tribes had a couple of good ones. And so we're going to pick it up with that in a few moments. For an opening question, I want to pause for just a second, and I want you to turn to your neighbor or your small group or your family members, and I want you to answer this question. If you could have any superpower, what would it be and why? So take a few moments and talk amongst yourselves. If you could have any superpower, what would it be and why? All right? Take a few moments to do that. Well, I hope you had a great conversation, and we're back again talking about God's best story here, and we're having a conversation about kings. Hope your conversation around superpowers was kind of fun. There's actually kind of a, if you're a guy and you grow up in America, you talk about this anyway. Guys just talk about, I like this superpower, I like that. So I'm going to even challenge you another one. What superpower of a major Marvel comic or DC comic would you like? Like DC comic is like Superman or Batman, and the Marvel comics, of course, are like Spider-Man or Hulk. So I want you to take another time and turn to your neighbor and say, which are your super comics or superheroes or from which comic series and why? So are you more of a superhero fan of Superman in that group, or are you more of a Marvel comic fan? All right, take a few moments and talk about that. Hi, I'm back again. Hopefully I didn't start any fights tonight between superheroes or super comic people. I'm just going to lay it out there. For me, I always go through this with my son Joshua, and I always try to say, you know, what would be my favorite superpower? And, you know, obviously Superman seems like he has a lot of them, but he does have kryptonite, so that's kind of a tough one. And I think for me, that what I've chosen the most is probably to travel time. I just think it'd be really cool to be able to set things right, but it'd probably mess them up anyway. But so time travel is kind of one of those things that's kind of a cool superpower. But anyway, I hope your conversations went well. And we're going to pick it up with God's grand story and Judah's king. And one of the other questions I'd like to talk about is kind of in this section, we see this thing called angels. Now, angels are a lot like a superhero because obviously they're messengers of God. They can appear mysteriously. They have inside knowledge. And they are depicted with wings. We're not sure that they literally have wings, but we do know that they can show up at a moment's notice, whether it's flying or transporting or how that works. And so we see where that's an important part of this section here. So what does the world tell us about angels? What are we often taught that they look like? God tells us in his word that angels are very powerful. And every time an angel appears to someone in the Bible, the angel has to always tell the person, guess what? Do not be afraid. I don't know why that is, but every time an angel shows up, it's like people just freak out, right? And in Old Testament, New Testament, doesn't matter. It's like the first thing out of their lips are like, don't be afraid. And usually, don't worship me, because it must be this holy presence. I'll tell you a story. I was with another pastor today, an area pastor, and he may come share this story at our church. But he had a near-death experience where he encountered angels. We've also had several people at the Crossroads Church encounter angels. Some inside the church building, some outside the church building. And so that's been something where it's been kind of cool to have conversations with people who have literally seen angels on our stage or literally experienced angels talk to them. Well, this gentleman had a near-death experience and encountered angels. He was a pastor, and he had this really bad asthma attack. And when he had the asthma attack, he had his daughter, who's in seventh grade, call 911. Well, before the ambulance got there, he passed out. He doesn't remember everything. He knows that he was picked up by the ambulance, and he woke up in a hospital. But he also had this incredible experience where when he had died, he literally, his heart had stopped. He said that he awoke to the presence of angels. He said that he literally felt like his spirit being ripped from his chest. And he had this experience where he left his body and he could look around. And he said it was like floating above the ocean. You could see as far as you wanted to, but no matter how far something was away, that you could still see it. And he said as he turned around and stopped looking at the earth and looked up into the sky, he saw tens of thousands of angels just worshiping. Now, can you imagine that vision? And he said he had a hard time explaining to us what those angels even look like. He said they don't look like they look like in books. They didn't have wings and all that, but yet they were somehow floating or flying. He said there was a sense of they were just illuminating light. And he said that the music was like something he had never heard before. And he said what was really amazing to him was that in the midst of this incredible vision of all these angels, all of a sudden Christ himself appeared. When Christ appeared, he said, like, it's like the angels just had this kind of fury and they all bowed down to Christ. What was interesting, I thought about this story, is in the midst of all this, I asked the question, I said, well, what did you say when you saw Jesus? And I thought it was an incredible answer. He said, I asked if you'd take care of my wife. In other words, when he passed away, he was concerned and still worried about what would happen to his wife when he was gone. And when Jesus talked to him in this vision or when he went to heaven, in this near-death experience, Jesus said, it's not your time yet. And he anointed him, and then he woke back up in his body. But what's incredible about this story is how this person, one of the first things he saw when he died and went to heaven was these angels. And likewise, I think that's why people are afraid when they see them. They think, all of a sudden, angel of death, right? Or they think, like, why am I seeing an angel? What's going to happen to me? And so they appear in these stories in these sections. We begin to have this understanding of God is sending these messengers to be very direct with them, to say, this is some things that you need to understand are going to happen. And so as you read today's section on the best story ever, I hope that you'll follow the questions, you'll have a fun conversation, follow up on the superpowers, and you'll even maybe have a great conversation about angels and what they represent. Let's pray together. Gracious and loving God, we thank you for this time together to study your word, to converse and think about superpowers and super beings like angels. And Lord, we just pray that as we have our conversations in families or in small group, Lord, that you would just watch over those conversations, that we could just really draw closer to you and closer to your word as we engage in God's word this year, particularly through the Hebrew scriptures. And we pray for all these things in your name. Amen. All he had in a castle made with